There we are.
Hey guys, it's Elizabeth, and I like to start the show with no glasses on, but I can't even see if it says we're on air live. If I don't have
it. It says live.
So happy Thanksgiving, everybody, and I get to be here with one of my BFFs. Watch it right now.
Hey. Hi everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. Hope everyone had a nice weekend.
We haven't seen you for a while.
I know. Sorry. Not because I'm not in love with you. It totally is.
Are you out living your life?
I'm out working. This has been a very busy work year for me. So busier than usual. So, and I sit there and I do things and I go, gosh, I really would love to make a video about la la la. And then it's just been a little bit of a crazy year work wise. So.
Well, I prefer that you spend your free time hanging out with me to making videos. So I'm
like,
what can I say? So how was your Thanksgiving?
It was really, really nice. We actually celebrated family-wise last Sunday because now that our daughter's married, you know, she's got multiple layers of families. There's step family and everything else. And so we did that last Sunday, but we ended up going to.
But wait, I have to say, I'm a little impressed because Kirk was in town last Saturday. And we all went out last Saturday night, and the next morning you did like Thanksgiving where you like had homemade cornbread and all kinds of things.
Thanks. Yeah. I was amazed myself that that could still occur.
Gracie and I could barely like roll over. So I'm just saying we're impressed.
Thank you. I was like a little focused.
So I interrupted the rest of your Thanksgiving. So.
Oh, no. So, for regular Thanksgiving on Thursday, we ended up going to my daughter's new in-laws. So that was really fun. They have a humongous Italian family and they're from Sicily. And so they do American and Italian style Thanksgiving. And so there's tons of festive American trimmings and then there's tons of pasta and everything else. So it was really cool. It was really neat. And like 25 people there. It was really fun.
So what was the best food that you had over both Thanksgivings?
Well, it's funny you should say that. First of all, for my Thanksgiving, I make my grandma's dressing or stuffing, as people call it, recipe every year. And that's made with the cornbread. So that, for my Thanksgiving, is always my favorite. But for the Italian Thanksgiving, which I don't eat pasta, and I haven't in three years, basically. I mean, I really abstained from it. I maybe had a bite here or there, but I had pasta and it was so good because it was the real stuff.
And what kind of sauce did you have on your pasta?
What kind of what?
Sauce.
Okay, so they mix a bechamel and a traditional marinara together. It was crazy incredible.
I have no idea what bechamel is. What is
that? Bechamel is like a white sauce that it's just like a creamy, yummy. Oh, just it's sinfully awesome. So good.
And that's what we do on The Naked Truth, you guys. We talk about Jack in the Box and pasta. Just because that's what all weight loss surgery patients want to talk about, right?
Let's talk food.
Particularly those of you who are on pre-op diets during the holidays.
Oh, bless their hearts. Oh, my gosh.
Really quickly, I just want to do community celebrations. So first, two of our other, I mean, everybody is our BFF. So let me just put that out there. You guys are all our people, but two of our very special people have things this weekend. Well, this isn't really a thing, but Amy is on the very downhill slide of her chemo. I think she only has 3 chemo treatments left. So I just want to give a big, huge shout out to her and tell her that we love her and that we're grateful for toilet paper too. So, and it's Sarah's birthday, Sarah Harrison Robison. It's her 23rd birthday today.
Happy birthday.
23rd, whatever. But anyway, I want to give her a big, huge happy birthday. And then on Facebook, Gretchen did her local turkey trot on Thanksgiving with 3 friends. 2 were WLS sleevers from her hospital and fellow YouTubers, Maggie Ruth and Nikki VSG. Her goal was to beat the time of the color run she did with Emily, which was 50 minutes with a 5-year-old. She ran about 2.5 miles of it and finished in 39 minutes, 58 seconds.
Whoa.
Averaging 12.3 miles. Woo!
Awesome. Good job. Wow. That's impressive.
Yeah, that's very impressive. And she looked very cute doing it, if you didn't see the pictures on Facebook. That's my thing that I realized. I haven't really wanted to run an official 5K, but then somebody pointed out to me that I could like actually get a time that I could then strive to beat, because I do tend to be, I don't know. Have you noticed that I'm a little competitive, Patti? So because I'm a fundraiser, and one of the things I did for many years was 5K fundraisers, I had like no desire to ever do this as an actual person participating in one, but now I'm kind of getting drawn by the competitive aspect of it. So
that's awesome.
So that even though I run a 5K every day at the gym.
Yes. Which is very impressive.
Just have to throw that in. So I may actually have to do it in an official one so I can get an official time. Jamie Lynn Sorrell has been struggling at 180 to 185 pounds with a goal of 169. And she has been at 179 for a whole week. Yay!
Awesome.
With a slice of the best berry pie ever under her belt. So she's hoping it stays. So that is awesome. Stephen Lang is on Optifast. He says it is not delicious, quoting Scotty Arnwhite. Optifast, I kind of like the chocolate Optifast. You did Optifast too, right?
I like the soups. Yeah.
The soups were really good. I like the tomato soup a lot. So do they have that in Canada, Stephen? So, but what that means for Stephen is that he's getting close to his surgery date. So that is awesome. Sarah says it's her birthday and she'll be 23, which I already recognized. Tina Watkins Goldworthy is celebrating hot flashes.
Oh.
I'm waiting for those to show up. They should be doing them. I haven't had them yet. I'm not sure why.
You haven't?
No, I've never had a hot flash. Well, if you ask Gracie, she would say I'm in one continual hot flash because she's freezing all the time and I can't stand not to have air. But like an official hot flash? No.
Well,
that's nice. Melissa Capps, who just recently had surgery, is down 10 pounds. She had surgery on 11/16/16, and she's down 10 pounds since then. Janine, which is, I think this is this the Janine that I met in, yeah, it is the Janine I met in New York. What's her, a Pinkfish Lily? Mm-hmm. He says she's celebrating this, and there's a picture, but I can't tell what it is. So if you guys want to go to my Facebook page and look at what Janine is celebrating this picture of, you are welcome to. It may be a pet. I'm not sure, but because I'm blind. So Lindsay Manoush is 1 year out. She's Lindsay Lou RNY. She has lost 95 pounds since her surgery date at 138 pounds total, which is awesome. Robin, who is Phaedra on YouTube, who I thought was, never mind, but I met her in New York and she was very different than what I expected. And she is celebrating.
I have to step away for a second. Sorry, I have a little party foul going on here. Sorry.
So Robin is celebrating her resiliency, not having lost any weight for 8 months now, and even a recent 5 pound gain. She had her week-long Thanksgiving Day binge and found out that all food didn't make her any happier or less stressed or less depressed or anything. So rather than wait until the new year, which is the old Robin, she is starting now. She's done with sweets, refined carbs, and grazing at will. To quote me, Liz, protein, produce, and water. And yes to a shake for breakfast and packed lunches and a 30-minute walk at lunchtime. So yes, I'm celebrating resiliency.
Awesome.
Very awesome. And let me just really quick before we get started, let me check in to see what's going on in chat, because I'm sure there is lots of activity in there. What do we have going on in chat? And sorry, guys, Amy says it's really annoying when I don't look at the guest, and that's why I should always have a co-host. But it was Patti, and I don't know, I just felt better.
She has to look at me all the time.
I look at her all the time. So if I'm looking at the screen,
She's like, I'm
kind of sick of her. look at her. I can never get sick of looking at her. But, okay, so who's here? Teeny Tiny Tummy from Christine is here. Lindsay Broussard is here. Melissa in Tennessee, VSG. It's her first time being able to watch live, and she's trimming the tree at the same time.
Thank you.
That's awesome. Margaret Lewis is here. Ash gets sleep. Oh, Scotty's here. Scotty, you don't usually watch us live, do you? Al is here. Let's see. Margaret Lewis says she didn't get home in time, so she has to sneak off in a room over at her friend's house so she can watch us. She's so rude. You know, you are so awesome that you would sneak into a room at your friend's house and watch us. Gretchen's here. Macaroni and Sleeved is here. Macaroni and Sleeved had a community celebration on Instagram, but I can't remember what it is. Tell us in chat and I will announce that. But I remember seeing something on Instagram. Let's see, Indira, I'm paranoid about saying your name because I think I'm saying it wrong. Indira broke her stall and is at 139 pounds. I saw that on Instagram today too, and it made me very jealous.
She weighs 139 or she's
lost? She weighs
139. Wow, what's that like?
I know, right?
I was more than that when I was born.
Sleeved after 60. Monica is here. Scotty says no tomato Optifast in Canada. That's a bummer. And I should have known this. Christine, teeny tiny tummy, had a birthday also, and she's lost 20 pounds in the last 2 months.
Awesome. John, Christine, that's awesome.
And I will be seeing her and anybody else who wants to come. I'm going to be in Chicago we're going to do a dinner December 10th in Chicago. So if you live in Chicago and you want to come, Facebook message me. Let's see. Oh, Gretchen says that Janine is celebrating her new puppy, Giuseppe.
Aw, cute.
Very nice. Let's see. Who else is here that I haven't already mentioned? Sleep. Yeah, that's right. Sleeve Rocker is getting his plastics done next week. So he didn't put that under community celebration. So Pete, congratulations to you. That's super exciting. Oh, Macaronian Sleeve is down 60 pounds, but didn't you also hit Wonderland or something? Something I saw. Indira says I'm not saying her name wrong. Pete is here. Esther VSG Trek is here. Okay, awesome. Very good. Okay, you had like, because it's Patti and she's so popular and she had like 9 million questions and we're probably going to be, the show's probably going to be 2 hours long.
It's you, not me.
No, it's you. But first, for the person who may be watching who has no idea who you are, which I can't imagine that that's the case, can you give us your just kind of general story about weight and weight loss surgery, et cetera, et cetera?
Sure. So I'll go back to my beginning of before weight loss surgery. I was at my highest weight of 360 pounds in October of 2013 and decided at that point I really needed to do something. I'd just been diagnosed pre-diabetic. I had sleep apnea. I also have chondromalacia, which is in my knees, and that's not going to go away, but it's much less aggravated with weight loss or with less weight. So decided at that point I needed to do something. My dad died an early death and I was going down the same exact road. I'm 5'10". At the time, I think it was 45. And so decided that I was gonna go down the road of weight loss surgery. Did the pre-op diet of Optifast and lost 70 pounds leading up to my surgery, which was April 15th, 2014. Elizabeth and I met in January of 2014 through our same insurance provider, and this became an amazing friendship, which I'm so blessed and grateful for. So on April 15th, 2014, I had RNY gastric bypass. And so
what was your weight on your surgery day?
290 on my surgery date. So 360 to 290, and then I reached my goal in July of 2015 of 180 pounds, which I wanted to lose half my body weight. And then now I went ahead and had plastics on my front. I'm just going to call it my front side because I'm getting ready to have more done. But I had a tummy tuck with muscle repair. I had a breast augmentation, breast lift, and I had some liposuction on my thighs. And that was in December. That was December 1st, 2015. So 1 year ago. Dr. Katzen did my surgery and I lost 10.5 pounds, but I also had implants put in too. So that changes it up a little bit. Right now, my weight is hovering about 162, 163 pounds. I've seen as low as 161 recently, which would be my lowest weight.
That's not that far from 139, honey. I'm just saying.
Well, maybe. Okay, so now I'm
getting ready. It isn't, trust me.
And now I'm getting ready to have more plastics. So I'm getting ready to have the posterior body lift done. So I initially didn't think I was going to have more than one surgery. I wanted to be one and done. But now I am having the posterior side done. What it's really interesting, what I've noticed, and I've talked to several people in the weight loss surgery community, but once you have your front done, if you had a lot of junk in the trunk, it just kind of feels off balance a little bit. So I'm having that all removed. I'm having a little bit of revision. Do you want me to go into this right now? I'm sorry. You asked me one question. I'm going.
No, it's all good. But wait, let me just interrupt one second, because Gretchen commented that her daughter is watching us before going to bed, and she saw you and asked, why is Cinderella not wearing her dress?
Oh, get her a smooch for me.
Right? I mean, hello. Okay, can I tell you guys, I'm sure everybody knows this, but at OH, they had a costume contest. We were the Disney princesses, and I have for a while called Patti Cinderella and Gracie Snow White, so it seemed like a very natural thing for us to do. And I swear to God, we were at a hotel that was not that far from Disneyland. They could not get through the lobby because little kids were asking them to stop and take pictures with them.
That was so cute.
It was very cute. And it was very,
like, oh my gosh, if you ever want to feel good about yourself, dress up by Disneyland.
I know. But my favorite picture is the one with Gracie sitting on your lap eating a patty melt.
I love that picture too.
A little cannibalistic, but whatever. Margaret Lewis says she has been watching you since before she knew all about the weight loss world. So, which is awesome. Which,
wow.
I mean, I didn't know anything about this until Patti either. So she has somewhat created a monster. But anyway, let's talk about the plastic surgery then that you're going to have coming up in just the 12th?
Yeah, it's December 12th. And so I'm having a posterior body lift. So basically, it's going to just basically finish off. It'll be like having a 360. I'm having a little bit of revision done on my breasts. My breasts dropped some, not the implant, but my skin actually stretched more, which isn't uncommon, of course, with us who have skin that's used to stretching. and then what else am I having? I'm having, once he removes all this in the back, he is going to do a fat transfer to my butt. So I have, because otherwise I'm going to have no butt at all. And just a couple things up here, nothing, just a little bit of liposuction up here, just to kind of, I like the curviness, and taking off this bottom is going to change my curviness. So it's just going to kind of contour things a little bit for me. And anyways, so that's on December 12th. It's going to be another big one. This one's actually going to be longer than my last one.
It is. With the hernia, can I have the exact time so I don't start to freak out like I did last time?
I have my final pre-op appointment tomorrow, and I will find out the exact time that he expects it's going to take. I am going to have an additional surgery though too. Do you want me to go down? Sorry.
Yeah. What additional surgery?
Oh, okay. So this is December 12th. And then because this is a long surgery, I'm having my arms done January 30th.
Okay. Right. Okay. But so the first time, and Indira had said she wanted all the information Patti had about plastic surgery. And Indira, I just want to direct you back on the, I don't know that they're all on the new Naked Truth channel, but I will move them over in the next day or two. But we did multiple shows with Dr. Katzen, who was Patti's plastic surgeon, and I think those would be really great for you to watch. I know some of them are on the new Naked Truth channel, but I will make sure that I move the others over in the next few days so that you can watch those, because we've talked, a lot about that in the past. Now, when you had your original plastic surgery, what I was talking about was they had thought it was going to be X number of hours, and then they found a hernia. And so I was getting all anxious because I hadn't heard anything from your husband.
Yeah.
And I figured, well, he's probably anxious, so I don't want to bug him, but what the hell? is happening. But your surgery was how long that first time?
I want to say it went probably 9 hours, and I think this one's scheduled with it currently, it's probably going to be about 10.
Okay.
And the thing about last time too is they got a little bit later start. So it was supposed to start at like 6:30 in the morning. I think it didn't start till like 8 or 8:30. So that kind of pushed things a little bit further out in the day too. So.
Okay. Well, real quick, I want to look at if there's anything new on chat, and then I want to jump into the questions because you have so many questions. We usually don't get them. Questions. Okay. So, let's see. What watch Adrian Shrink is in the 250s, which is awesome. And she hopes everything goes smoothly with your plastics. And then Monica has a question that's going to come up later because somebody else already asked it. And Lynn Thou, your mini me, says, I love getting an update from Patti. What a true inspiration. Now, Lynn, who we met in Nashville, looks just like Patti, only teeny tiny. Patty's tall. She's like way taller than I am. And Lynn looks so similar to her, only is like the teeny tiny version.
That's a nice compliment. Yeah.
Macaroni and Sleeve wanted to know if you were seeing Katzen for the revision work, which you are. And Rhea Reloaded is here. So let's go your questions. So just in terms of comments, I think Pete was excited that you were gonna be on the show. He posted a cute emoji.
We're ready to recover together.
That's true. Brooke James says she can't wait to see you, that you have very much impacted her successful journey. Sarah's excited that we're having the show on her birthday. Okay, and a question. Lindley, who we also met at OH and went to Disneyland with, wants to know if there is anything you would change about your journey.
Well, that's a great question, Lindley. Yeah, actually there probably is something that I wish I would have handled differently. And this is all a maturation process, even being close to 50 years old, you still learn a lot of new things and life takes you different places. But I really wanted to be in the closet about my surgery out of the gate. And I required that of everyone around me who actually knew. And so I had family and so forth who, you know, I asked to basically lie to people. You know, if somebody asks you, just don't tell them. Since then, I've kind of grown away from all of that. I actually, you know, if somebody asks me now, I tell them. I'm not shouting it from the rooftops. It's not that I'm not proud of it. I am. It's just, you know, people have gotten used to the new me so much that they don't necessarily ask how I lost weight anymore. But I just wish I would have been upfront and honest, and if somebody had a problem with it, which was my greatest fear, that I would have just been able to put that where that belonged and not really listen and just and you know, of course now I'm having to do cleanup and that kind of thing, and that's not fun. So I just wish I was open about it. That's all.
And can I tell you how absolutely amazingly proud I am of you for doing that?
I love you.
I know that wasn't easy for you. And I mean, you have been doing a lot of work and that's part of it. And I am just super proud of you.
Thank you, love.
That is all. And Lindley also wants to know what your favorite NSV has been.
Oh gosh. You know, it was so funny. I was trying to think about that earlier today. What's my favorite NSV? And the reality is I don't really think I mean, there's certain poignant ones that stick out more than others, but there's not an absolute favorite. I think every single one, even at this point out, we still have NSVs. And each one is just such a personal triumph and joy and experience that I love each one.
Wasn't there something the other day when we were out that was an NSV that was like really weird? What was it? I can't remember.
We get them all the time.
Life is one big NSV. That's my favorite.
Yeah.
NSV that I actually am living life.
Absolutely. We just went on a vacation and going in a helicopter I wouldn't have even attempted that before. And it was funny because, of course, you had to weigh before you got on the helicopter.
Actually, you have to weigh on a scale?
You have to weigh, yeah, because they have weight limits. And so it's funny because I was like freaking out, of course, because, you know, the old persona, we still have to fight that ugly demon. And, you know, 240 is the weight limit. I'm like, what if you weigh over 240? And he's like, then you buy another seat. I'm like, okay, all right. Well, so there is a possibility. He's like, oh, I've had people in here that weigh 600 pounds. I'm like, oh, okay. Well, that's good.
So. Okay. Precious has a very important question. She wants to know, can she be like you when she grows up?
Oh, Precious.
Really, I love her. Can I be like you when I grow up, even though I'm older than you?
She is so cute. I love her.
Seriously, if there's one piece of advice you could give to a pre-op patient that you wish someone had told you prior to surgery, what would it be?
You know, I feel like through YouTube and through our surgery program that I felt well prepared and loaded with what I needed to be successful or know what the tools for success would be. So I guess anyone who's going to have surgery, I would just say get engaged in YouTube and make sure you follow people, because the wealth of information out there on YouTube is beyond measure of, I think, anything else you can get. So, you know, shows like Talk Elizabeth and the things that you do for the community, and you know, it's all from the heart and it's all from a passionate side of being so much in gratitude for having a second chance at life, and you can't get that anywhere else.
So tell me about, and I don't even actually know the answer to this question. Most of these questions I already know the answer to. How did you get into YouTube and who did you watch first? I should know that, but I don't.
No, you know, that's a good question. So I have a friend who had the sleeve, and I'm like, how did you, because I had never even heard of the sleeve before. And I'm like, how did you hear about that? She's like, oh, YouTube. So I just started going on YouTube. I didn't even use YouTube before. And I'm like, gastric sleeve, you know, da, da, da. And then all these people started coming up. And I remember the first person, oh my gosh, she's down in San Diego. Amy SD Mom was the first person I ever saw. Then of course I saw Less of Sarah, and a whole bunch of others. And I was like, wow, this is amazing, these people's journeys. And that's how I found out about it. She just mentioned, oh, I looked it up on YouTube. I'm like, oh, well,
I remember the first time you talked about it in class, and you were like, it was like after you had gone to that All of Me screening, and you were talking about like Chris Waffle and Sarah Spoon. I'm like, why do all these people have food names? And she was talking about, I mean, it's so funny now because now I know those people, but it's like, she's talking about them like people should know who they are. And none of us had like watched YouTube. And I didn't look at it then, but then you started making videos and I started watching those. And I only ever watched yours. I didn't watch anybody else's. I had asked you for recommendations of other people and you gave me Less of Sarah and Jen.
R&Y for me.
R&Y for me, who I love. And I love Less of Sarah too. And I mean, all these people that I started watching who are now like personal friends, some of whom have rescued me from very precarious positions. And it's just so, I'm grateful that you discovered YouTube.
Oh, well, I'm grateful for the fact that you're consistent and you're such a beacon of light to so many people. And
blah, blah, blah.
I wish I did that.
I'm going to go, like, I'm going to do two questions and then I'm going to go back to chat just so we can keep up because I'm sure, oh my God, because there's a lot of activity going on. Let's see. Gretchen says tall chicks rock. Spring Bishop is here and she says she loves us both, of course. And she wants to know what exact revision is being done. You want to talk about that?
Sure. So my breasts have just dropped a little bit, not the implants. They're where they belong, but I had some still my own breast tissue and it's just kind of sagged down a little bit. So it's getting lifted and, I'm having one more conversation with Dr. Katzen tomorrow. I unfortunately, I'll probably have a better idea of the whole thing tomorrow because I just want to get some clarification on a few things. But we may be changing out my implants. So anyways, basically they're getting lifted a little more.
So the revision is on her breast, and then she's getting her, she did not have a 360 originally, so she's getting that extended. So that's what, I mean, that's not really a revision. That's just a.
No, that's all new.
Yeah.
That's all new.
And
I am having a little revision. It's not a revision, but I'm having my Mons kind of flattened out a little bit too, because there's just puckering there. And so if he's going to be there, might as well do it.
So guess who is watching, who is our close personal friend who we don't see very often anymore, who I miss like crazy.
Oh gosh.
Scary. The real Share Bear is watching.
Oh, Share.
Scary. You never watch. I'm so excited you're watching.
Love her. How cute.
She says,
baby.
Hi, gorgeous friends. I miss you both. So I hope to get out there to see you again really soon. We hope the same exact thing because, Sherry, my meat is waiting for you.
Well, lucky you, cause I never had it.
Patti has never tried my meat. Okay. Wednesday, I'm going to have some meat for you. So
all right.
We can take it and eat it somewhere else where Dale Cooper isn't, but I will make some meat for you. Indira says short chicks rock too. Hello. Yes, we do. Let's see. Macaroni and Sleeve wants, we're going to be on here. Do you have more than an hour? Because we have way more than an hour's worth of questions.
Yeah. As long as everyone else is good with it, I'm good with it.
Okay. Macaroni and Sleeve wants to know, do you wish you had had a 360 initially, or do you feel like doing it in two parts is better for recovery?
Well, hindsight being 2020, now that I'm having two surgeries, my goal was to only have one. And so now that I'm having two, of course I wish I would have 360'd and then done my breast, but oh well. Yes. But to answer your question, yes.
So, I mean, here's how I feel about it. I feel like I'm learning from the experience of my friend.
Yeah.
I may actually, cause I never really thought I needed a 360 because I carried all my weight in the front, but I may actually consider it now. Scotty texted me and says, tell Patti that it is a fantastic answer about how she feels about her NSV.
Oh, thank you. You know, it's funny about that whole NSV thing. There's so many things in life that you experience too since then that you think you'll never, I mean, some of the things that you and I both have done since, you know, everything. It's like, who would ever think that I'd do that?
I mean, even today, there are like, I didn't do that much today, but there are like 20 things today that I did that I would have never been able to do.
No, you would have been on the couch, right? Because it's raining.
I would have been on the couch 3 years ago without a problem, but I like had all these boxes in storage. I mean, like a 50-pound box I carried up this like two flights of stairs and wasn't even like out of breath afterwards.
Awesome.
You know, I mean, okay. Anyway, Indira wants to talk a little bit about body dysmorphia. Do you feel like you don't see yourself as your thinner self, or how has that kind of transformed for you?
I actually feel like now, okay. So psychologically at times I get concerned that I'm not going to fit in something. When I say fit in something, like fit in a seat, or like when we were going on the helicopter, I was freaked out about stepping on the scale. I don't mean to laugh at that. It's just, it is, you know, but as far as I think I see my body for what it is. Now I can look in the mirror now for a long, long time, even after I lost all the weight. I mean, probably in the last 6 to 8 months, I've been able to look in the mirror. Whole body.
I also had that issue, really. I mean, I think I had, my shapewear is sticking out from my Liz sweater. I had a body dysmorphia issue before surgery in that I thought I was thinner than I was, but I don't think I've really, I mean, I think I probably think I look better than I actually do.
Okay.
So there's a lot more chat stuff, but let's go back to the regular questions. Brooke wants to know when you're going to make an update.
Brookie, I love you, darling. I'm going to try, and I'm just so proud of you. You look so flippin' fan. Every time I see a picture of you, I'm like, wow, look at her, my little butterfly.
Yeah. What do you think about going back on a week or two of a liquid diet? This is also, Brooke has a couple of questions, so we're going to go through this.
I guess, you know, if it works, tonight I'm having, I don't want to say I'm on a liquid diet. I'm not at all. I'm just getting ready for surgery. I have to have 100 grams of protein, and my restriction's crazy right now. I don't know why, but anyways.
I don't drink wine, and I got this for Patti, and then show what you're drinking.
Well, I already finished it. I'm trying to get ready, but I won't say, you know me, I have my wine, you know. But
well, that's the next question. I know we're never supposed to drink. That clearly happens. I can't find anything that doesn't make me very buzzed within a couple sips and doesn't make me sick. Any suggestions?
All I can say is, I don't remember. I think Brooke's are in wine too. I don't do sugary drinks. I can't. It just the thought of it, it's kind of like ice cream. I can't eat ice cream. It just makes me nauseous. Like I can't do a margarita or anything like that. So what I found is like I can even do really white wine, just the sweetness of it. So I drink red Pinot Noir usually. That's my first choice. And I will have a glass and I will feel it right away. And of course, then it filters out pretty quickly as well. But I haven't had any problems with that. I'm not encouraging you to have that, or, you know, I am not your sommelier. However,
but what's your, I find that I can drink more than I could pre-op, but I'm BSG. So when do you find that you have a few sips and then feel very intoxicated and then it clears quickly, or what's that process for you?
Yeah, I feel like once I get to about a half a glass of wine, I'm feeling it. I'm just feeling real buzzed, you know, just a buzz, not drunk or anything like that. If I have more than, you know, a glass, if I have a glass and a half or two glasses within a time frame, I'll feel drunk. But it does go through my system very, very quickly. So, yeah, definitely.
So Tina Watkins. She says she can't wait to see me and, of course, to meet you. She is, I don't know, she discovered the Naked Truth when CJ and Shrink was on. So she's discovering all these people she'd never heard of. So nice. I kind of feel like for her, it's like finding out that Breaking Bad is a series and you have all the seasons to watch. Because
did she make videos?
No, I don't know. Tina, do you make videos? Last week, she didn't know who Gracie was or who Melly Mae was. So Gracie's taken down all her videos, but Melly Mae, I think, still has her videos up. So I feel like, oh, wow, I wish I had all those videos still to watch. Lisa VSG English is looking forward to watching. Trish Shells Park says, here's one, Patti. Mm-hmm. Whatever, repeat it. Where have you been? I love, love, love your videos. Please make more soon.
Thank you. Thank you. And I'm not even going to commit. But I would like to get back in the swing.
Okay. Let's see what's going on with chat. Sorry, guys. I'm not looking at you. Okay, somebody's in Knoxville and is going to meet up with Sherry, which is good. Lynn Furlong says she loves this show. She looks forward to Sunday nights because she gets to watch me and all the awesome guests. I have learned so much. I have told so many people who are interested in WLS to watch, so that's awesome. Chevrolet VSG is watching. She says, with so many on Keto Pound of Cure, do you believe in moderation or deprivation? Okay, and can I just say this? So you guys know I have come to the point where I believe in moderation, but Patti has like been so on point for so long, it's kind of incredible. Just saying.
You
did not have macaroni and cheese until like last week.
Yeah, right. And I have pasta too, but I'm not breaking down. That was just a holiday.
That was a one-time thing. saying, I get it, but I mean, you are really consistent. But what's your thoughts on moderation versus deprivation?
I guess it's kind of like whatever works for you. I don't think it's a blanket statement. I honestly, like, I know me personally, it's probably a deprivation thing that would be looked at is like, I know my slippery slope, so I just don't even go there. And anymore, I don't miss things. It doesn't, I'm pretty used to this way of life. So for me, I guess it's deprivation.
And I bet, yeah, I think you're more deprivation than moderation. Not the deprivation in a bad way, but I mean, I think that's where you go to more than moderation.
Yeah.
But like, you could probably answer this question, which I couldn't, even though it hasn't been a lot. How many times have you had bread since surgery?
Oh.
Not that many, right?
Maybe two.
Yeah. See, I haven't had it that many times, maybe 10, but I couldn't tell you.
Yeah, I mean, maybe two, maybe three. and when you say bread, it's like a bite.
But I just have to say that the idea of me saying that I have only had bread 10 times in 3 years is
huge.
Yeah, it's kind of huge. Macaroni and Sleeve says, she's talking about you. I'm not sure I totally get this, but what the hell? Your under eyes are so gorgeous and like a model.
My what?
Your under eyes? I'm not sure what that means, but
I have makeup on. But thank you.
Tina says, hello, beautiful Liz, and nice to meet you, Patti. I'm here. Sorry I was exercising. Let's see. I'm looking for questions. More Patti and Liz, yes, please. Okay, we can do it every week for sure. We do that every week. Sherry says, so jealous of the plastics. I'm having to weight again like I did for VSG, but I'm definitely going for the 360 breast lift and arms, probably spring of 18. Awesome, Sherry. I'm probably not going to do it till fall of 17, so we won't be that far behind.
Is that our share bear?
Yeah, share bear. Spring of 18, yeah. Okay, let's go back to our Facebook questions, even though there's lots more chat. Scotty wants to know, do you find that you're more confident doing things in public now?
Yes. Yes.
Would you like to elaborate?
I'm
just kidding. I said, would you like to elaborate?
Oh, yeah. Oh, actually, you know, it's funny to say, it's not just like, how you show up or what you wear, but even just like in business and so forth. I used to be like, there's a certain sector of the market. I'm a real estate agent. So there's a certain sector of the market I wouldn't even go after before, because I just didn't have the confidence that people would look at me seriously because I was over. I mean, I know this is so terrible to even say, but because I was super morbidly obese that people wouldn't take me seriously. And you know, the people who knew me and loved me, they were good. They knew my heart and they knew I would do a job for them. But I wouldn't go after people I didn't necessarily know. And the other thing, too, is probably, you know, the whole stint with the whole modeling in this last year, which, of course, that's a crazy NSV that nobody would ever even. I mean, come on.
Yes, they would. Don't say nobody would ever. Yes, they would.
No, I know. But you know, you wouldn't ever think that you'd be. I would have never thought I would be doing that.
Okay, so, you guys. Okay, go ahead.
So what I was going to say is, and it was interesting because a couple times where, getting back to Scotty's question, I worked with people who were regular, the normal size model, and then I worked with some plus size models. And these girls, I mean, they owned it and they owned themselves. And here they are, 27, 25. And I was like, and she's like, girl, this is what you need to do. And I was like, wow, this confidence is crazy. And it taught me a lot. And I felt like her name's Lizzie Miller. She actually models with Ashley Graham a lot. And she just brought it out of me. And I'm like, okay, you know what? If she shows up in the world like this every day and she's this beautiful, curvaceous, just bombshell. But you know, she's just a fun girl and she has a great time. And I was like, I can do that too. I mean, what am I afraid of? Just be you. So anyways.
Yeah, and that's so weird because that's what I feel like I have now too, is this confidence to just show up in the world as I am and be not only okay with it, but I don't know, very confident about that. And I've, so even though from the very first moment I met Patti, when she was like, I don't know, what were you the first day I saw you, like 350?
Yeah, probably close, 340, 350.
The first day I saw her, I was like, she is gorgeous. I want to be friends with her. And little did I, so that was like at 350. So, but I've seen even over the last, you know, year, a huge change in you in terms of your confidence.
Hopefully it's not cockiness. That's all. I want us to remain Patti.
Yes. You're not cocky. You're Patti. So, Scotty also asked, has your new body image given you a sense of confidence that you might not have had before? You look fantastic.
Oh, thanks, Scotty. Delicious. Just kidding. I'm just thinking of what he says every video.
Delicious.
I guess after plastics, last year after plastics was hard emotionally, and I won't psychologically feel the same. It's just an emotional thing. It's, you know, when you lose your penis and this protective layer around you that you've had for all this time, and you feel so exposed, and just, there was just a ton of emotion that I had no idea was coming my way. And I know you remember that, Elizabeth.
I was going to say, do you care if I talk about my perspective on that?
Please, I would love that.
So, I mean, here's the thing that this is where I'm so fortunate in having friends in the weight loss surgery community, and even friends who are going through plastics before me, is to kind of watch how this happens. And, you know, Patti had lost like 200 pounds, right?
Yeah. At the time, 185, 190.
Right, like 200 pounds, but that was over a period of time. That was over like a two year period of time. And she looked incredible, and the difference was huge, but that happened over a period. And then I saw her when she was recovering from plastics, but I will never forget the time, like, I think it was one of the first times that we went out to lunch after you were like back on your feet, and we went to that, I don't know, what was it, like a Vietnamese place or something? I don't know. But you were wearing the red sweater and the leather pumps and the jeans. And it was like, holy shit, she is a totally different person. Even though she, you know, was probably, what, like 10 or 15 pounds different, was mm-hmm. swelling, mm-hmm. the way you looked was totally different. And I was like, that has got to really fuck with your head, because even though you've lost 200 pounds, that's happened over a period. This happened over 2 months. You went from being beautiful, being a bombshell over 2 months. And I mean, I just looked at that as like, that has got to fuck with you.
Mm-hmm. It was just interesting. To wake up from surgery and have all that gone was just like, whoa. Yeah. I wouldn't take it back or not do it again. Believe me, the post recovery, you know, and getting through all that, if you can do it, you'll be happy.
But I just really, for the first time, Dr. Watson has said this on our shows, was that there's, you know, there are issues with depression and other things following plastic surgery. And I think part of that has to be with, you know, all of a sudden, I mean, I'm going to be doing this whole series of videos that are more on the emotional and spiritual part of growth from this point forward. And part of that is, you know, there's a reason that many of us have this layer of protection that's fat. And then all of a sudden that's gone. And when you say that, when you say your panis is gone and all the stuff that was, even though you'd lost the weight, was still there, I mean, that's a very vulnerable place to show up in the world with.
Yeah, I just remember feeling so exposed and like I was gonna injure myself really easily, and it was just really interesting. I don't know. But again, as time has gone on, it just gets better and better and better.
Okay, what time? Oh my God, we're already at 5:50. Okay, let's go and look at chat, see what's going on. In chat, people are meeting up in Knoxville, I guess. Let's see. Tina VSG Chit Chat is here. Carolyn Ponce is here. Sorry, guys. Watch Adrienne shrink, so she's going to have to pimp herself out to afford plastics. Probably me too. That's probably going to happen at some point. Miss Beautiful Alicia is here. I haven't seen her on chat before. She says getting rid of the panis was the best thing. Oh my God. Okay, I think that's all. Oh, somebody wants to know what fupa is. Do you want to say what fupa is? Oh, somebody. Never mind. Sherry said it. I won't put that on you.
Thank you, Sherry.
Okay, Rhea wants to know, at this point, what's the most difficult part?
Oh, wow, that's a good question. Okay, probably, and you know, we go through so many different stages of growth through all of this, at least for me. and I'm always one of those people who's kind of a late bloomer in things, so it's interesting because you go back through time and you go, gosh, I've reached this huge goal and milestone in my life. And although we have tons of support, we truly do this on our own because we make a decision to do it. And it is so empowering because you realize afterwards, I can do anything. And it's interesting because like probably about between 5 and 7 years ago, I kind of had another experience with this. And it was like more of a group thing where we did this financial planning seminar. And we were under the guise of we were helping our kids so that they could get ready for their marriage and their future and everything. But I thought, gosh, we could use this too. And it completely overhauled our lives. Just that 5 minutes of focus each day on the finances, it completely changed our financial picture. And so to me, it was like, okay, that little focus taught me something huge. Is if you do the focus every day on what needs to change, and then taking it over to weight loss surgery and our weight loss journeys and that huge change. Those are two big areas of life that goals have been met. And so to get back to Rhea's question, I just say that now that I've faced kind of my biggest challenge of my life that I viewed as my biggest challenge of my life, and if there's other challenges going on in my life, I'm not okay sitting back, not addressing them anymore. Everything has its place, yet everything needs to be addressed. And sometimes that might be a group situation where you aren't the only person in control of it and you're hoping everyone else around you is going to get on board. Or maybe they don't want to get on board. And so it can be a little frustrating, or it can be, you know, you just have to evaluate and make decisions on what's truly important that you, because I just think once we do this, we can do anything. I mean, anything we set our minds to. And so leaving things in your life where that need improvement, or you may not feel, you know, happy about that kind of thing, or things that just can enrich your life more, settling for not doing that is no longer acceptable, I guess.
So every year.
Did this answer the question?
Not really, but it's okay.
I'm just saying no stones left unturned anymore. It's just kind of like.
Which leads to something we talked about before the show about maybe talking about.
Oh right? So relationally, you know, go ahead, Lizzie.
Well, I was going to say, so every, and probably like the whole YouTube nation doesn't know about this, but every year I do a, Kirk just texted and said, sorry, he's missing our show live, but he'll watch it in 90 minutes. So, okay, Kirk, we're going to shout you out. You're forgiven. So every year I do a holiday letter, and what I tend to do is put out the 10 things that have been most important to me in that year. And so it used to be that I really struggled with those 10 things. And now there are so many, but one of the things is one of the hardest things that I had to do this year, which related to my friendship with Patti. And do you want to talk about that, or do you want me to talk about it, or because I do think it's important.
You're starting well, and I'll interject if necessary.
Oh, I get to talk about it. So, So, I don't even know how to talk about it. So I met Patti at Kaiser, and I always looked at her as this person who had this perfect life. And I think that made me, even though I wasn't like totally aware of it, it made me a little jealous in some ways of that here's this person who is my close friend who has this perfect life. And my life, as you all know, is far from perfect. when we went to Nashville, I started to realize that maybe it wasn't exactly what it wasn't exactly as perfect as I thought it was. And I really started to think, okay, like, you know, maybe I need to change the way that I think of and relate to Patti, because I have these ideas in my head about her that aren't really accurate. And then I went into like post-Brian blah, 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 blah psychosis, where I was really upset and heartbroken. And during that period of time, I felt like you were pulling away from me. Right? Say something. Give me something.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't want to go too far. So I felt like she was pulling away from me. And I felt like that might be because Patti is a very private person, and I was being very open and upfront and a little nutty, right? Yes.
Oh yeah. No. You were. Yeah. I was concerned. I was concerned at moments. Yes.
As most people were who were friends with me. But I thought that had to do with. I mean, I really did in my head thought that has to do with Patti judging me for how I'm showing up. Well. So a couple times I said to her before we were getting together as in a group, I had said, is there something going on between us? Because I'm feeling something different. And what did you say?
My denial answer. No.
Right. Okay.
My typical answer.
So I really felt it strongly. And I was like, okay, she can be saying no, but I really don't think it's no. And so before I went to my brother's wedding in Columbia, I sent her an email, and I hope I'm not going to.
Oh, it's fine. No, you're not. I'm glad you are. I think this.
So I sent an email to Patti and said, listen, I'm not going to ask you this again. And there are going to be group situations where we're going to be in, and I can be fine to just be, you know, passing friends, but I really love you. And I know that something is wrong. So if when I get back, you want to talk about it, I'm good with that. And in my head, it was all about how crazy I was being over this heartbreak. So I sent her that email, and she responded that, yes, she wanted to get together once we got back. And we did. And why don't you talk a little bit about that?
Well, we ended up meeting for lunch at a restaurant that we've met at many times before and have a history of there. And anyways, I think I don't even know how to explain it, but it was just like the most honest, raw conversation I'd ever had with you about my feelings about us and think. I don't even know how to say it. Elizabeth, you can say it better because I was just bleh.
Well, all I can say is my food hadn't even come, and I was like, oh my fucking God, how do I get out of here? But I mean, and I think this is probably one of the reasons we became friends initially is like neither one of us were that gung-ho on confrontation.
Yeah.
And I think the fact that both of us showed up there that day spoke to how important that this friendship was to us. But
I'm just gonna make me cry right now.
No, I mean, I have never felt, I don't even know if it's confident, but I felt like, okay, this friendship is important to me. I had no idea what she was going to say. What she said were things about me that I will accept, but was not expecting. And it was really hard to sit there and hear it from somebody who, in certain respects, I felt like was one of my closest friends. But we did. And I don't even like now know what the point is of bringing this into this conversation, but it's like that leaving no stones unturned. I have never, maybe in romantic relationships or in family relationships, I have done this kind of confrontation, but that Patti and I could sit there and have this confrontation about things that were difficult for both of us to say when neither one of us liked to do that was pretty fucking huge.
Yeah, I think we both had ideas about each other that weren't, like what Elizabeth was saying about me, a perfect life, and what I, you know, what the ways I felt about her that weren't actually accurate, as far as they were more in our mind,
right,
than the reality. And it was a chance to get that out. It didn't probably come out very eloquently, but it definitely took our friendship to a completely different level and understanding. And it is like,
it is
important to bring up because we always hear about these relationships that fizzle out or peter out, and so for the fact that we salvage this and have taken it to another level, and we have so much more fun even now, which is hard to believe.
Yeah, I mean, so much more fun
because the honesty is so, she knows I'm messed up. She knows I don't have a perfect life.
And everybody in the world knows that about me. But
just kidding.
Right, exactly. But the most difficult thing, it's not just about weight loss surgery, but I think it's about life. That it's like when Patti said, don't leave any stone unturned, it's like this is a second chance for all of us. Weight loss surgery is a second chance to experience life. And there are not, all those moments are not always good. And that, I mean, I swear to God, I was sitting there in that restaurant thinking, fuck, my food is not even here yet.
I remember the look on your face. You're like, oh, wow.
It had always been so mellow and nice and whatever. But the friendships that I've made through the weight loss surgery community are the most important friendships that I've had. And I'm afraid to even look at chat and see what people are saying about this. But this one particularly, that we went through this together and came out on the other side, where now I know, I mean, I used to think I can't tell Patti this because she'll judge this or whatever. I mean, I know I can tell Patti absolutely anything. And it's because we were willing and then some. And it's because we
I'm gonna love you, and I'm not gonna judge you, and I'm gonna know that, and vice versa for me as well.
Yeah. And I so appreciate you.
I don't have to put on a persona of perfection with you at all anymore.
Right. So.
And that's the bigger problem with me is the facade world versus the real world. And if you haven't read The Love Warrior by Glennon Doyle Melton,
read it right now.
Just because
anyway, that's our like love story. But anyway, it was just really something I'm going to write about in my Christmas letter, because I have never sat through. I mean, I think part of being overweight is you don't like to sit through uncomfortable shit. You would rather have a cheesecake.
Right.
And I appreciate you for showing up, because I don't think you particularly wanted to either.
I was afraid. And then we ate a whole chocolate molten cake. I'm just kidding. We didn't.
I know we did not. All I remember is me saying, oh yeah, and Brian was married, and then that directed the whole conversation. You were like, what? Because she had been sort of out of the loop. But
yeah.
She had stopped watching my videos even. Can you imagine anybody who would do that?
No.
I can totally imagine people who would do that. But anyway, so in terms of the most difficult part, I mean, I think being vulnerable with your emotions and being willing to risk for relationships, because that's ultimately all that matters.
Yeah. So. I agree.
Anyway, now, Terry Santiago asks,
hey, Terry. Aw.
What is your mindset for success?
I don't forget about this any day of the week. I don't, every single day I mean, I don't know if this is my mindset for success, but every single day I give this focus. I just do. It's like, I go back to not everyone gets a second chance at life, and I'm entirely grateful for that. Could I exercise more? Heck yeah. Are there things I could do? Yeah. But I think just being honed in every single day and not living in any state of denial about what we've achieved is going to keep us on the path of success. Because denial gets you to 360. That's all. You know, it got me to 360.
What's the point? Okay, but Monica says, and I'm going to take you up on this. Monica says, Liz, if you stop talking about Brian for 30 days, I will give your charity $100.
I don't know, Monica.
I'm down on that.
I'm going to double down.
Okay, Gina Davis Institute on Gender and Media. Today is
11/27/2016. All right, let's check right now. We'll see if it can happen.
No more Brian. I actually deleted all the pictures and video off the phone today. Oh my God, that is so funny.
You need to live and feel. So.
No, I'm like, really, Lindsay said she'll punch him for $100. and watch Adrian Shrink wants to post a video of it on YouTube. Teeny Tiny Tummy says, the friends I've made the last couple of years have taught me to accept true friendship and know that my friends love me for who I am.
Yeah.
And Monica says, Brian was married.
That's a whole other Oprah.
Pete says he needs to find a large sum of money so he can connect with all you wonderful WLS Pete. And Pete, I just have to say, Scotty said above that my life is perfect because I got to meet him. You could have come to that meeting. Okay, this is really funny. The comments are really funny and they're really inspiring, but we'll pass because I'm not talking about him anymore. Lindsay Manouche wants to know, what are your keys to maintaining your weight loss?
I definitely watch my portions. I take my vitamins every day. I drink the water. I follow the rules.
How often do you weigh? What's your weigh?
Every day.
Me too. Yeah.
Yeah. So sometimes I weigh every day. Like, I didn't weigh this morning, but like, wow. Yeah.
But generally, do you think that helps?
Totally. That probably more than anything. You know, I am a fear-based person, so to speak. Like, fear works for me. And so, you know, that helps keep me in a state of reality.
Lindsay Broussard wants to know about your Kybella experience. She wants to
thanks for asking. So I only ended up having one treatment so far. And here's the thing. I like it. I think, what do you think, Liz?
I think I can definitely tell a difference.
Yeah, and like my husband's like, oh yeah, I can tell a difference.
I think I will be saving money for Kybella. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, Kybella is great. It's interesting because I do self-tan sometimes, and I notice anytime I self-tan, it doesn't matter. The wrinkles kind of show up. But if I don't have any self-tanner on my neck, it looks pretty. I mean, what I want it done as far as the wrinkles to go away, I think it's tightened up, definitely. And there, I could probably use one more treatment, and I'll probably do that at some point. But I'm going to get past this phase of plastics before I do that. Because that whole waddle thing is just uncomfortable for me.
No, you can tell a big difference, I think.
Yeah, and, I mean, I'm looking right now, and I can tell.
I don't see it at all. Yeah, I mean, I never really noticed about you on video. I mean, I could see it in person, but I noticed the last few times I've seen you that I don't see it at all.
Oh, okay, good. Well, maybe I won't have another treatment. I'd like to not.
Another question from Terry Santiago. She wants to know, which WLS rules are really a challenge for you to follow and which are a breeze?
Okay, well, there's a couple. I chew gum, so that's the one rule I break. I know we can drink this.
Chewing gum like a no, or is swallowing gum a no?
Well, swallowing. That's why they don't want you to chew it, because they're afraid you might
swallow it. Follow it. I mean, who swallows their gum?
Yeah, I know. What WLS rules do I break? I have a cocktail once in a while, but besides that, I really don't break any
coffee through a straw.
What?
You drink your coffee through a straw.
I drink my coffee through a straw. I drink pretty much everything through. I drink my water through a straw.
And your coffee. Tell us about your coffee drink of choice right now.
My coffee drink of choice, and this is a meal for me.
Right.
What?
Your coffee drink of choice is so fucking good.
It is really good, but it's calorie-wise and everything else, it's not that great. But if it's a meal replacement, it's okay. So it's a chili mocha from Starbucks and with coconut milk with whipped cream on top. And if my mom, I don't even know if my mom knows we're doing this tonight, but it's my mom's favorite too, by the way. I got her
hooked. My favorite now too. And I have not had I've done it maybe 3 times, but it's really, really, really good.
It's like a little bit of a dessert, and I have to slow play it because, you know, being R&Y, there's sugar and stuff in it, but it is incredible. And I know it might sound weird, chili, but it's kind of got a cinnamony, it's kind of like a Mayan mocha type of, it's
and just the salty taste on the whipped cream.
Yeah, and they put this little salty chili on the whipped cream.
It's so what WLS rules are a breeze for you?
They pretty much all are. Like, I think the hardest one was probably, I think, you know, if you can start working on them before surgery, that totally helps. Like, probably the hardest one for me to break. I love Diet Coke. You know, I used to drink Diet Coke like crazy. So the hardest thing, I just like the carbonation. So carbonation was hard for me to break, the hardest. But I haven't even thought about it, honestly. And I haven't had carbon. I just don't do it. Yeah. So.
Are you hungry yet? Still?
No, I'm
okay, yeah. So I just have to say, if there was one reason I would hate Patti, it was for that.
It was that.
It would be that. But she is not.
Ellen has not returned yet for me.
Hunger has not returned. Yeah. And I don't know. It's sort of a mixed bag about that. I sort of feel like I appreciate my hunger because that's telling me my body needs food. But I'm a little.
Your body will tell you another way. It's interesting because even though I don't have ghrelin or, you know, and I don't have that hunger pain, I have a definite energy change when I need
to. You feel it. But you're pretty, I mean, don't you like eat every so often pretty much? Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not as good about that as I used to be though. Like I used to eat like 5 or 6 times a day and now I'm eating like 3, sometimes 2. You know, and not a lot. My restriction at times is like right now it is crazy. And I'm sure that's just, even though I'm not nervous at all about upcoming plastics, I'm sure there's something going on in the back of my head, you know, with that. So.
Okay. Jody. Hey, Jody.
Hey, Joe.
Says, being this far out, is there anything you miss about the past you?
You mean the heavier version of me?
The heavier version of you, yeah. The pre-weight loss surgery version of
you. Not really. I feel like I'm the same person, just in a different body. So, no, there's nothing. There's nothing I miss about that body, I can say, just because that was a prison, you know. And it represented a lot of, although I loved myself then, I totally did, there's nothing I miss about that body, and hopefully I'm the same person. At least I feel like I'm the same person.
I feel like you're the same person until I see one of your old videos pop up.
When you go back to, it's funny because I met with a friend today who I hadn't seen in 3 years since my journey started. And one of the reasons, God, she might be watching tonight. One of the reasons why she is a fitness fanatic, and she's like, I'm going to help you lose weight and we're going to start walking and we're going to, and she was a chiropractor and she's like, we're going to tape your knees and da da da. Well, I stopped talking to her because of course, that accountability, I wasn't ready for it. So when I saw her today, we both cried. We both were just like, she's like, no freaking way. But I was going somewhere with this. What was the question? Sorry.
I don't think I asked you that question. I just was joking about how the fact that I think you're the same person until I see one of your old videos.
So she went home and she started watching me. She's texting me. She's like, oh my God. you know, so I think that you can see a confidence. If you go back to my first video, and I've watched that several times, there's definitely, you can, I'm, nobody's comfortable their first time on video anyway, right? So you have that factor. But then you also have the factor of, you don't know your people you're talking to. So now we're friends with everyone and so forth. It just brings out a different level of confidence when you're out there. Like right now we're sitting here talking, I feel like I'm talking not just to you, Lizzie, but to all of our peeps that we know and love, you know, and it's so nice. I mean, gosh, how unique is this world we live in?
It is the most amazing thing ever. I watch my old videos and I'm like, why did I talk so slow? I talked very slowly back in the day. I don't know. But yeah, this is, I mean, I got to tell you guys, YouTube is YouTube and all you people out there on YouTube. I mean, I met Patti before YouTube, but everybody else I have met in this community has been from YouTube. So make videos, comment on videos. I mean, it's a pretty amazing, incredible thing. And I feel like of the things that have changed in my life over the last few years, losing 200 pounds was a big one. But learning how to have relationships with people, and most of that has come from this community, is a huge part too, because I didn't know how to do that before. Yeah. Okay, let's look at chat one more time.
Right.
See what's going on there, and then we'll go to Inside the Actor Studio questions, which I know you've answered before.
I've done that before. Do I have to do it again?
Good to do it again.
I guess we're probably going to change.
Oh my God, what do we have? I can't even keep up with this. People calling Brian a douchebag, the We Hate Brian Club. Sorry. Okay, then no talking about Brian starts tomorrow. Oh, that's so funny. Tina's like, who? Okay, seriously, who is Brian?
It doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter.
Knowing Tina, no worries. Macaroni and cracks me. Macaroni Sleep says, look at Liz's video crying on a bridge. Like May time frame, I think. It was actually June. What is Kybella? Okay, an actual relevant question that's not about Brian. You want to say what Kybella is?
Yeah. Kybella is, okay, so what's that?
Sorry.
That's okay. So I'm trying to think of the body part that your gallbladder. Okay, so you have gastric juices in your gallbladder, and basically Kybella is, it's a, think of Botox or think of fillers for your face, that kind of thing. Kybella is an FDA-approved drug, and when they inject it into your neck, it melts the fat in your neck. Most of my neck fat had melted, but what I was left with was a lot of like skin waddly type of looking, you know, crinkly skin. Uh-huh. And so the dermatologist that I go to, he told me, he's like, you know, let's try it on you, because some of my patients who I've done it on, their skin has tightened up. So I was kind of a guinea pig for him, and we did it. And I just did it one time, but it's usually usually between 3 and 6 treatments people do, depending on their level of fat and so forth. So that's what Kybella is. And it's K-Y-B-E-L-L-A. You can look it up. There's a lot of different information. I have 2 videos I did, but I never did a follow-up to it. But here's your follow-up.
We will tag this as Kybella. Okay. Sorry. Because I only have till midnight, and then I'm on a 30 days kibosh. Yes. Rip Rat says, Brian is a cheating douchebag that this day is.
You should take all these comments and put them down in a book.
We're finding out. Well, I put this actually, okay, so here's something, you guys. I'm getting different advice on The Naked Truth on whether to do it through my regular channel or through a different channel, because the new channel doesn't have as many subscribers. And so this one is on my regular channel, which I do have a feeling he may be watching. So, but Brian is a cheating douchebag that Liz dated and fell for before finding out he was a lying, cheating douche. And she found out while visiting him across the country. It's a long story. Teeny Tiny Tummy for Christine says she just bought 3 canisters of Fit Frappe, which is her new favorite coffee drink, which I also love. Losing It For Me 42 says she totally needs Kybella. Yeah.
Check it out.
Teeny Tiny Tummy says, what the fuck, Patti, still no hunger?
I know. I believe me, I'm as shocked as you are.
Sleeved After 60 says my $100 charity donation begins at midnight, so I'm good with that.
Okay.
Margaret Lewis says, I don't drink alcohol or coffee and I don't like sweets. I've noticed a lot of VSG and RMY post-ops partake of these things. Patti, do you crave or eat anything that you didn't pre-op?
Crave anything I didn't
no, anything new that you crave now that you didn't crave pre-op. I crave like vegetables and healthy food now, which I didn't.
Yeah. I want good food. It's funny because I have this psychological thing. It's like my stomach's really small and I want to protect it. So there's only, you know, the only bad thing I'm going to put in my stomach is wine
and coffee.
Yeah, and I honestly drink decaf. So the only time I drink caffeinated is when I have that chili mocha, just because.
I was going to say, I don't think the chili mocha drink is decaf.
Yeah. So I drink decaf at home. I have a crazy, I don't sleep very much as it is. I have a really hard time staying asleep. So, I just don't do caffeine.
Okay. Okay, sleeved after 60. Monica wants to know if you ever wished you had a VSG.
No, I'm not living in regrets about that. I that was my original thinking I was going to have that. But no, I'm.
Mm-mm. I mean, I know. You're like, I don't. Usually it's the other way around. Do you, I mean, like to me, I get a lot of times, do you wish you'd had RMY? Which, yeah, maybe I sort of do.
Yeah, I don't, I'm not going to say I don't dump. I know I can take it to a dumping place, but I just don't take, I don't push things. It's like, you know what? If I have a dumping situation, which I may have one once a year now, and it's just totally unexpected, and all of a sudden my body's reacting to something. So,
yeah. Lindsay Broussard says she doesn't think she would have been nearly as successful if she hadn't started a YouTube channel, and she also wants to know about the cost of Kybella. And we live in a really, it may not be as much, whatever Patty's going to say, it may not be as much where you live.
Yeah. So my, first of all, Kybella here in Newport Beach, the Newport Beach area, that's where my doctor is. It's $600 a treatment. He did it for half the price for me because he just charged me for the actual medication, because I was, like I was saying, was going to be a guinea pig. So it was $300 for me. But I know all across the country, these kind of treatments are different prices. So just check it out where you are. Yeah. I could see him being upcharging stuff just because, well.
I mean, I'm sure where we live, it's more expensive than it could be in other places.
Yeah, and he's got celebrity clientele. That, not that that matters, but, you know, he can charge.
And it's just, I mean, yeah, it's Orange County. Okay, so I think that's all the questions. Is there anything else you want to talk about before I go into our
there's one thing I was going to bring up that I thought, if it came up through the questions, which I probably just missed it, but one of the things that has been most gratifying through this process is people reaching out on Facebook. So not necessarily weight loss surgery patients, but like, which I've had plenty of people in the community reach out and that kind of thing, but regular people reaching out, and they don't have 100 pounds or, you know, sometimes it's 50 or 60 pounds, and just meeting with these people. And that has been like kind of my new call for purpose within this whole thing. So I'll meet with people and I'm honest with them. I tell them I have weight loss surgery. Clearly it's not something they need to do, but they're always, I tell them that because I don't want to be like, you know, obviously we don't want to lead people down a road of, you know, craziness, but I still leave there. And they're so grateful just for the motivation that comes from the conversation, which is really neat, because I always think, oh, I'm going to tell them I had weight loss surgery, and they're going to be like, oh, of course, you took the easy way out, right?
So many, I mean, right. It's nuts. I feel like at this point, it's not about weight loss surgery. It's about the fact that I do things differently.
That's right. And now that we're years out, and I'm not saying we're not like Tanya in 5 years out, right? That, but there's still a track record, and there's still the behaviors there, and people see that, and it motivates people, and that's been super gratifying. It's been as much a gift to me as it is to them. So I just wanted to let you guys know, if you have an opportunity to meet with just normie people or whatever, do it, because you will motivate them and inspire them, and I will drive anywhere to meet somebody.
Yeah. Absolutely. Me too. Because I just feel like, I feel like, honestly, if I can do it, anybody can do it.
Exactly. And it's so. On bottom line, as we all know, you know, if people say, is it food? Is it exercise? And I'm like, okay, well, that's the 80-20 for what you put in your pie bowl, of course. And then also you need to exercise, but it's 100% right here. And until you decide here, nothing's happening.
Yep. Okay. What's your favorite word, Sunshine?
My favorite word will always be love.
What's your least favorite word? And don't say yummy.
And I'm not going to say moist either.
Don't say moist or yummy.
Yeah, definitely not. My least favorite word? Liar.
What turns you on creatively, spiritually, or emotionally?
Two things. Water and music.
You mean water like the ocean or water like a 16?
Water, the sound of water, rain, the ocean, whatever, you know, water in different forms.
We've had a lot of rain this weekend, which we usually don't have. And I was looking out my window today and there were rainbows all over the place.
And it was so nice to wake up to.
It really was. What turns you off?
Egotistical, ignorant people.
What's your favorite curse word?
Oh, come on.
What sound or noise do you love?
Oh gosh, I'm gonna say water again, but I love hearing people laugh. I love that.
What sound or noise do you hate?
People arguing, fighting.
What profession other than your own would you like to attempt?
Other than my own, I'd like to be an independently wealthy retired person.
Yeah, a lottery winner. Yeah. Yeah. Maddie and I don't want to work. We just want to hang out all day together.
I say, why do we have to work?
I know. Always. It's like, fuck these people who are trying to make this work. So, what profession do you
want? At least we do like what we do at the core of what we do.
We do. It's absolutely. I just would prefer to have about 12 hours more a day of free time. What profession would you not like to do?
I was a waitress one time. I'm super klutzy. I was such a bad waitress. So bad. Do you know how many things I broke, spilled? Yeah, bad.
If heaven exists, what would you like to hear God say when you arrive at the pearly gates?
Well, to me, heaven exists. God is real.
Me too.
And I would love God to say, welcome. Baseball and let's party. And here's everyone you've been missing. Yeah, I miss my dad dearly, and that was the most heartbreaking. So
we will be on here next week. I have no idea who the guest is going to be because I have put feelers out to multiple people who you guys will be really excited about, but I honestly have not followed up because I just haven't. So somebody will be here next
week. Still living life.
Somebody will be here with me next week. Thank you, Patti, for
thank you, my love. I it's been a pleasure, and thanks for letting me do this. I miss everyone, and it's thanks for the questions and for the love. I love you guys dearly, and I'm so proud of everyone. So proud. It's an honor to be part of this community.
Ditto. And I'm so proud of you.
Thanks, babe. I love you.
I love you. And so we'll see you guys next week with somebody. I don't know who, but we'll say it on Saturday. So have a great week. And I will see you tomorrow on my regularly scheduled video. Bye, guys.